Yeah, Shalom, Israel. First of all, I want to give a praise to the Most High Yahweh, Hashem, Yahshua. Yeah, today's lesson I'll be touching on today is basically pride, man. Because I'm meant to do this lesson might have been a couple of weeks ago, man, or even a month ago, man. But obviously, the Spirit kind of jumped onto me today to do the lesson. Today, man, to bring out today, man, because obviously nothing wrong with doing breakdown videos, but obviously you gotta make sure you're in the right spirit when you're doing these breakdown videos, man, because you don't want to be doing these breakdown videos and still be having gotten that you don't be doing these breakdown videos and be having that you don't be having that prideful spirit in you, or that wicked hatred demon spirit in you when you're doing these breakdown videos. You wouldn't be doing these videos when you got a righteous spirit on you, man. You don't be doing these videos and you got strife in you and you got envy in the heart, man. You'd be doing these videos. You know what I mean? Make sure you're doing these breakdown videos when you got a clean heart in you, man, and you're bringing out the word properly, man. Not bring out the word of any hatred or envy in the heart, man. So yeah, man, so the more side put the spirit in me today to do this breakdown video today, man, because I had this breakdown video sitting in my notebook on my phone, man, for a month, man. But the spirit came to me today to do this breakdown video today, man. So yeah, man, so let me bring it out now. Enough of rambling on, man. Yeah, man, before I get any precepts, man, when I read this little what pride means, man, in the dictionary, man. So bear me. Yeah, so basically pride means basically a noun, a high or in, it's lucky, a high or in hoard. It's like a high or in node, denote opinion of one's own dignity, importance, merit, or superiority. Like whether as cherished. It's lucky for that. Whether as cherished in the mind or as displayed in bearing, conduct, etc. The state or feeling of being proud. Go to the verb now. To indulge or plumb oneself in a feeling of pride, usually followed by on or upon. So let me get one more the definition of pride, and after I'm gonna bring out some precepts after this lesson ain't gonna be too long. It's thought I'd bring out today, man, touch on basically pride, man, because it's not a good thing to have pride in your heart, man, because pride can get you killed, man. Pride is a wicked spirit, man. Obviously, I know everyone's got a little bit of pride in them, because obviously we're still in these fleshful bodies, man. But a lot of brothers and sisters in the truth, man, should be having that wicked prideful spirit in you, like how you was in the world, man. Like, you should be bringing that prideful spirit that you had in the world, man, into the truth, man. That's off, man. So let me read this last bit about pride, man. So pride, it's the first point, a feeling of deep pressure or satisfaction derived from one's own achievements. See that? The achievements of those with whom one is closely associated, or from qualities or possessions that are widely admired. The team was bursting with pride after recording a sensational victory. So, and read his last three bits after, and I bring out some precepts after. So, it's a second bit now. Consecutiveness. Slack if I got it wrong, man. Of one's own dignity, he swallowed his pride and asked for help. So here's the last bit now. Be especially proud of a particular quality or skill. He prided himself on his honesty. So let me see if there's any more bits after that. If I ain't got any more bits, I'm gonna bring out some precepts. So let me get what does it mean to have pride? So what does it mean to have pride? Pride is a feeling or satisfaction which you have because you are slacking. Let me see, go a bit closer. Because people close to you have done something good or possess something good. They can look back on their envious with pride. Pride is a sense of the respect that other people have for you, see that, and that you have for yourself. So let me read one more bit after and bring out some precepts. See that they got wicked pride thing. I don't know why they got that there, man. I was typing what does pride mean, not pride month, man. See that. So let's see this voice last bit means. Here's the last bit about pride, man. What does it mean to be proud? The quality or state of being proud, such as reasonable self-esteem, confidence and satisfaction in oneself, self-respect, pleasure that come from some relationship, a social occasion, achievement or possession that is seen as a source of honor, respect, etc. So let me see if there's any more bits. If they know more bits, I'll get some precepts, man. So yeah, here's the last bit. Yeah, after I'm definitely getting some precepts after this, man. So last bit, what does disapproving pride mean? So disapproving pride is also the belief that you are better or more important than one. Slacking, really against slacking. What does disapproving pride mean? Disapproving pride is also the belief that you are better or more important than other people. See that? Yes, I know, stole that. Yes. Pride basically means, man, because like certain people can be proud, man. Even though certain people in the truth, man, can be proud, man. Like certain brothers can bring out, can be doing a lesson, man. Not just a lesson, certain brothers can be bringing out in the house and buyers on the Shabbat, man. Like edifying the people, innit? And certain brothers can be prideful, innit? Like basically, like certain brothers might be prideful in the spirit, like saying, like, how. Like, just for an example, man, I could say, like, certain brothers can know these deep, dark sayings or dark breakdowns, man. All these, these histories, but when it goes back to the BCs and that, you can know all the histories, man, where your history is and stuff like that. You can get into the dark sayings and not to break down these not to break down Revelation, man, and break down Deuteronomy and what else can I say, break down these I say, man, know all these deep breakdowns, man. The brother can know all these precepts, man, all these dark sayings, man, and these deep breakdowns, man. And the other broke in the same cap, man, he cannot know all the dark sayings and all the deep breakdowns, man. But that brother that knows all them deep breakdowns and all them dark sayings and all the precepts, and that brother can in the spirit of pride, man, saying that. Obviously he might not say it, but obviously can show on his can show when he's bringing out and how he's unbiased, man. Because like certain brothers can be might know a lot of breakdowns on a lot of precepts better than that brother, but when that brother's bringing that precepts, man, he might have that prideful spirit in him as well, man. That like, to show that like, and to say that like, basically I know more than you know, innit, man. You can say like that's a spirit you might be going through, innit? Like you obviously you might not say it, but obviously like certain brothers that will see it in his the way he speaks or the way he's bringing it out, man. He can be bringing out in the spirit like how could be bringing it out like how I know my breakdowns are new, innit? Can I say am I trying to see that way I can break this down, man? Because yeah, man, because that brother might ask the other brother that knows him deep breakdowns, like how to break down that precept, and that brother can be in a prideful spirit, like saying, like, I'm busy, man, stop following my phone, man. Like, he'd be in a prideful spirit, like saying, like, you need to leave me alone, man, I'm busy with my rib or busy in my house, man, I'm trying to sort some stuff in it, man. He could be in a prideful spirit with that, man, or in a prideful spirit, could be in a prideful spirit, like to say, like, you've been in the street for like three. Or two or three years, man. You still don't know these deep dark sayings or deep breakdowns, man. That's off a cell, man. Because that's not what the truth is about, man. The truth is about edifying the people, man. Waking them up, man. Not to be putting brothers down, man. Because that certain brothers might be in the same camp. Certain brothers might be bringing out a certain way, man. And that brother might know better breakdowns or better ways how to bring it out better than that brother. But same way, can't be putting that brother down, man. Because that. Everyone's learning skills are different, isn't it, man? A brother could come to truth, the first day, and basically know all these deep breakdowns than a brother that's been in the truth for 5 years, isn't it? Because like, everyone's learning skills are a lot different, man. Because like, what I noticed as well, man. Look, what Akim, man. Certain brothers need to stop doing, man. Just because that brother's younger than you, man. Just because that brother's younger than you, man. A brother slacking, stumbling my words, man. So just because the brothers might be younger than you, certain elders, man. That obviously I'm not talking about certain elders in particular, but I'm saying in general, man. Certain elders, man. If that Jake, man, knows a lot of breakdowns than the elder, man. That's in the truth, man. That elder can't be in his feelings and say like to be saying that come trying to think that's lucky thinking the word, man. Yeah, that brother, that elder can't be in his feelings because that young Jake knows more breakdowns than you, man. It can't be in the feelings, man, because that everyone grows different, man. Should be happy for that brother, that young Jake, man, that knows more dark breakdowns than you, man. Should be happy, man. Can't be in the feelings, man. So let me get the first precept of today, man. One sec, because man, can't be a man pleasing the truth, man. You can't be scared to be saying things just because you're in the same camp, man. If the elder's got enough for you to say something, man, if they're not keeping it, thus saith the Lord, man, you need to talk to the elder after the camp or talk to the head of the camp and basically tell him what it is, man. So Slucky, I think someone's at my door once. Yeah, Slucky, I thought that was my door, man. See, I heard a lot of noise, man. You've got to be circumspect when not just when you're out in the house and bars. You've got to be circumspect when you're in the house as well, man, because any little things, man, not any little things, but when you hear something or hear like a loud noise, man, you need to check what it is, man. You need to be circumspect. You need to be on point, man. When you notice when you're out there in the house and bars, when you're in the house, wherever you are, man, you need to be looking around, man, to see no demonic or evil spirits, man, because yeah, man, cause a lot of living the last days, man, you ain't got no time to be gotta be on point in the last days, man. Can't be playing no games, man. So let me get the first piece of today, man, because it's just a quick lesson, man, touching on basically pride, man, because a lot of brothers, man, not just brothers, man, a lot of sisters have pridefulness in them as well, man. And all pridefulness and get you destroyed in the last days, man. To let all that pride go in his last days, man. If a young Jake, man, if a young brother knows more breakdowns or more deep saying dark sayings than the elder in the truth, man. The elder needs to applaud that brother that knows the breakdowns, but not to be putting him down. I don't want to be contacting him or basically not to be not when he's bringing it up, man. Not to be, not slack. What's the word? When he's bringing it up, man, you might be the same elder in the camp, man. And you might be a young Jake that's that might knows more breakdowns and more precepts than the elder. Might know how to basically bring it up more better than the elder. But same time, man. Each one teach one, innit, man? Because what can I say, man? Because when that young Jake might be bringing that one day on a Shabbat, man, on a Sabbath day, man, and that elder might be in his feelings to be saying that, like, when he's bringing out Matty, man, that elder might just be screwing up his face and basically not be saying Khan or bring it up, man. Might just be in his feelings to be thinking, what, how does this young Jake know more breakdowns or more dark sayings than me, man? Can't be in the spirit to be saying that, man, or be thinking that, man, because all that is a demon, and you need to rebuke that demon and get it off you, man, because that don't matter how old or young you're in the truth, man. If a younger brother knows more than you, man, that's it. The Most High put the spirit in him to know more than you, man. Can't be in the feelings to say why does this brother know more than me, or knows more precepts than me, man. Can't be in the feelings to be saying that, man. All that is prideful, man. Brothers in the truth, man, and yeah, brothers in the truth, until all that pridefulness go, man, because when all hells break loose, and when Jacob trouble kicks off, when race wars kicks off, man, when famine on earth kicks off, man, the Most High can put the spirit in a brother that doesn't know all the dark sayings, all the deep breakdowns, man, to get saved in the last days, and that brother that knows all them deep breakdowns, man, that brother might have to go through the afflictions what was about to come to pass, man. So that's what I'm saying. People in the truth, man, brothers and sisters in the truth need to be say again, harmless of the dove. No, say again, that priest, man, why is a serpent harmless of the dove, man? Can't just be saying what you want to say, and can't just be in that nigger spirit, man, to be saying what we want to say, man. So because need to be loving each other in his last days, man, not to be hating each other, man. Because you see what happened the other day, man, about that young sister, man, that young Eve, man, that got killed in Croydon, man, on the way to going, features going on the way to school, man. And basically, that's what I'm saying, that people are too, they don't like to take correction, man. They don't like to be told no, man. It's a young generation, man, that it's due to the curse as well, man. I should be evil to a brother. Same time, man, need to start loving their own people, man, because I think I can't remember what happened. It's something to do with some roses, man. Basically, the guy didn't like the roses or something like that, and he basically he's in his feelings, and he ended up stabbing the girl, man. It's off as hell, man. It's basically you don't see no Edomites or no other nation, man. They don't go through these curses, man. If they do, man, it's only a one time thing, man. It's not like every week thing, man, or every month thing, man. It's only our people that's getting licked down in these last days, man. So let me get the last piece of no slacking. Let me get couple precepts in, man. It's not gonna be too long, man. So just get three precepts, man. Slacking, trying to get some precepts. See that Satan trying to mess with my internet, man. Making it go slow, man. Sucky, man. So let me get the first precept today, man. Book of Proverbs, chapter 11, verse 2. Sucky, man. Proverbs 11, verse 2. When pride cometh, then cometh shame, but with the lowly is wisdom. So all that prideful spirit that brother's got in the truth, man, you need to let it all go, man. We live in the last days, man. Don't ain't brother seeing like what's happening right now, man? Israel, man. Israel and Gaza, man. Them two countries are going at it, man. It's basically gonna start now. It's gonna kick off very soon, man. It's gonna start for obviously World War III is kicked off already, but obviously that like, more things are starting to come to pass, man. Because I think I've got a message right now. Slack it, check this message quickly. It's basically saying, see, let me click on that. One sec. It's basically saying, it's not a battlefield, it's a massacre. See that? Israeli village near Gaza border lies in ruins. Rains. Journalist taken by the Israeli military to a village attacked by Hamas. Paint a chilling picture of its destruction. See that? Mad thing. Yes, actually, Major General, 39-year-old veteran of the Israeli army, called the attack on Kafar Assar a massacre. See that? So, judgment's going up, basically, man. I'm saying to watch, man, up, bro. Brothers and the truth, man. Obviously, worldly people don't need to be paying attention, man. Talking to brothers and sisters and the truth, man. Need to be watching, man, paying attention, man, because all hell's gonna break loose properly, man. And so I'm saying that, like it says, man, it says we need to watch, man. Watch, pray, fast, man, and stay in point in the last days, man. Stay in point, watching them. Yeah, it's got to stay in point in the last days. Got to be paying attention, man, being circumspect, man. You could be going on Instagram for news, man. Going on end times to get these headlines and these articles, man. To be knowing what's going on in these last days, man. Make sure you're going on end times headlines. If bro's got Twitter, go on Twitter to get their news as well. But me personally, I stick to end times, man, and basically other prophecies that bro's post on Instagram as well, man. Because a lot of stuff in UK, man, can't find that in America. A lot of bros that are in the truth, man, they post it on their Instagram, and I get to see it, man. And yeah, man. So all hell's breaking loose, man. Like, so nevertheless, man, let me get another preset, man, because got to be paying attention, man. Can't be obviously nothing wrong with watching camp videos, but obviously at the same time you got to be going on the end times, man, going on these BBC news, man, going on these deep news articles, man, getting that information, man, because a lot of stuff that they say on Good Morning Britain, man, on Jeremy Van, man, on who else, man, all these other on BBC news, man, most of stuff that they're not saying on they're not bringing up more stuff that they say on on end times headline, man, because like kind of Israel, man, that I think a lot of these Israeli people, man, they got beheaded, man. I think a lot of the babies got beheaded as well. So like, it's just showing that these people are not playing about in these last days, man. That's why I need to pray for us, repent, and stop having hatred among the people, man. So let me bring this out right now, man. Proverbs, I bring this out already. I think Brown already slack here. Actually, no, I don't think let me bring this up. Proverbs 11 verse 2. When pride cometh, then cometh shame, but with the lowly is wisdom. Actually, slack here. I think I brought it already, still slack here. Yeah, so Proverbs 8 verse 13. The fear of the Lord is to, slack here, the fear of the Lord is to hate evil, pride, and arrogancy. And the evil way and the forward mouth do I hate. So the Most High hates all that pride and wicked, demonic, evil spirits, man, that brothers and sisters may have on them. They might not recognize it, but obviously that it shows in a countenance, man. It shows when they bring it out in the highs and bias. It shows when you're talking to brothers in person, when it shows in your faithful expressions, man. When you're talking to a brother or sister, man, it shows, man. So can't hide the prideful look that a brother and sister may have in them, man. It will show, man, if a brother's saying that you got a prideful spirit in you, and he's not trying to a brother says you got a prideful spirit in you, man, and basically that brother the brothers and the truth in the same camp, you're saying you're moving on prideful spirit, man. You need to be taking that correction, man, not to be bucking up against a brother saying that I'm not moving proud, man, because All that means is you're not able to be taking correction, man. Because when you come to truth, man, you need to be able to take corrections, man. Be able to take corrections about when you're going off, man. For example, you might have not been keeping Sabbath day the right days, man. You might not be keeping the high holy days on. Can I say, man? You might not be doing the right things, and the brother might be correcting you. The Most High might put the spirit into the brother to basically not to rebuke you, man, but obviously rebuke you in like, righteousness to be telling you that like, how you're going off, and to be keeping the Sabbath day on Friday sundown to basically Saturday sundown, and not to be keeping the Sabbath day on these other days, man, because that. And it says in Exodus, man, it says in 6 days may work be done, man, but the seventh day is the Sabbath of rest, man. So yeah, man. So brothers need to be able to be taking corrections in the truth, man. Even elders in the truth, man. Elders can be going off as well, man. Not willingly, but obviously that. Obviously there's demons and wicked spirits around in these last days, man. So an elder might be going off, and you might have somehow might have got the precept wrong. You might have done something wrong, man. And that brother that's younger than him in the truth in the same camp, man. You might be telling them that basically you're going off, elder, man. You can't be doing them certain things. You can't be smoking weed, cannabis, or basically defiling, you know, or sleeping with your rib on the Sabbath day, man. And the elder could be proud as well, saying that who you to say that, man, I'm head of the camp, man. That's all that is prideful spirit, man. That means to me that the elder can't take correction, man, because that. Just because you're older in a camp, man, you need to be able to take correction, man, because that's what builds us up in the last days, man. Not just in the last days, but that's what builds us up in the body, man. Not to be having that wicked demonic and prideful spirit in us, man. Because see as well, a lot of these eves are prideful as well, man. A lot of these eves got that wicked demonic energy in them as well, because like when brothers in the truth, man, when they go out in the house of buyer and we tell our sisters, man, to basically put a dress on, man, start dressing well as just in that how our foremothers are dressing, that they don't that taking correction, man, that they want to say that how we can wear what we want to wear, man. We can wear these tight clothes, man, wear these clothes that show off the whole cleavage, man. All that is off, man. All they're doing is moving in a demonic and wicked harlot spirit, man. So then we get the next priest of him, man. So see how long, man. Get last three precepts in, man. Yeah, we get Philippians chapter 2 verse 3. Let nothing be done through strife or vain glory, see that, but in lowliness of mind let each esteem other better than themselves. So it's basically said, man, that don't let nothing be done by being done by strife, man. Not just when you're out there in the eyes and bys with your whole congregation, man. It's basically talking about even when you're doing breakdown videos, man. Even when you're speaking, man. Let nothing be done by strife, man. Because on the Sabbath day, man, you got to watch what you're saying on the Sabbath day, man. Because it says that in Isaiah, it says, man, you can't be speaking your own words on the Sabbath day. You can't be speaking about no folly, man. You can't be speaking about no boxing, football, man. No entertainment movies, man, that you might watch when you're not keeping a Sabbath day. You can't be speaking about them stuff when you're keeping a Sabbath day, man. So that's what brothers need to take into accountants, man. Because basically, so I'm saying, like, even me, man, kind of certain times, obviously I might do a breakdown video, but certain times I might just not take a rest from it, but obviously like, the spirit's in me not to do it that day, man. I won't do that breakdown video, man, because I don't want no strife to be going through me when I'm doing these breakdown videos, man. I like to be doing these breakdown videos in the right spirit, man. So let me get the next piece up in, man, because a lot of pride will get you killed in your last days, man. Brothers and sisters, you need to let all that pridefulness go out your system, man. So let me get Galatians chapter 6 verse 3. For if a man think himself to be something when he is nothing, he is slacky. Galatians 6 verse 3. For if a man think himself to be something when he is nothing, see that, he deceiveth himself. So if a man's maybe a guy in a Jake in a congregation, man, you might be the head of the camp, man. You might be thinking he knows all the dark breakdowns, all the dark sayings, man, but little things he might be going off about, little things that he might be not keep into account, not be keeping, is basically like loving his brother, man. He might not be showing brotherly love to his brother, man. He might be showing brotherly love to like three of the brothers in the same camp, but he might not be showing brotherly love to the other brothers in the camp, man. Might be saying Shalom King, Shalom, all praise to Moshe, yeah, but Shimon Shai to that brother. But when the other brother comes back to camp, man, you might just be saying yeah, Shalom. Yeah, man, might have that prideful spirit like in him like, to say like all that goes back down to is basically being a mem pleaser, man. Cause and bring that precept up in, so I can even get that precept now, man, about being saying a lesson about men pleaser, but brothers in the truth, man, should be being men pleasers, man. Cause if you I just took my own words, let me find them, man. And bring it up, man. Cause it can't be no men pleasers in the truth, man. That's off as well, man. What men on the earth, men in the dust and ashes, man. Can't be pleasing men in these last days, man. It's off, man. So let me get that priest off and get back to my lesson, man. So I get one priest of that, man, please. Let me get Galatians chapter actually wait. Okay. Yeah, let me get two priests after and jump back into my lesson. Let me get Galatians 1 verse 10. For do I now persuade men or God, or do I seek to please men? If I yet please men, I should not be the servant of Christ. So if you're pleasing men in the truth, but not just in the truth, man, if you're pleasing men in the world, man, at these workplaces, if you're thinking that you're gonna be calling your manager, boss, man, all them folly words, man. We're doing, man. You're not to be the servant of those. You're not the servant of Christ if you're thinking that your manager is the boss, man. Because me personally, I don't even call my manager boss, man. That's off as well, man. I say, let's call a name, or basically, yeah, that's it, man. I don't call them boss, man, because look at these people as gods on earth, man. They don't know gods on earth, man. These heathen nations are nothing on earth, man. Dust and ashes, man. The servants walking run on the earth, man. So yeah, don't look up to these even these hierarchies and managers, or these these people that walk around on site, man, on the construction sites, man. Don't look up to them, man. That's do them all the same way, man. But certain brothers, like, they might get scared, man, to say, like, oh, that's the management, and the boss is coming inside, man. Make sure you're not hanging around, man. Certain brothers move scared, man. That's a scared, wit, rory spirit, and should be having them scary, rory spirit spiritually in the last days, man. Even in the truth, man, you can't be scared to be saying stuff to the head of your camp, man. If he's going off, man, you need to correct him, man. You need to rebuke him righteously, man, with the scriptures, man. If he's going off, man, you're not telling him, man. All you're doing is, man, leaving blood in your hands, man, because that can let him to fall out the truth, man. That can get the whole congregation shut down on the Sabbath day, man. If the head of the camp, the brothers of the head of the camps, if he's going off, man, you need to rebuke him righteously, not to be saying nothing, man. You need to be rebuking him righteously, not to be stuff that happens in the camp, man. You need to address it there and then, man. Certain times you might have to address it after camp, but certain times if it's the brother's properly going off, man, you need to basically not rebuke him, but obviously like, say certain things to let him know what he was doing was wrong, man, righteously, but not to be being contentious, man. So then we get the next piece of him about people being men pleasers, man. So get Colossians chapter 2 verse 23, whatsoever ye do it heartily as to the Lord and not unto men. So don't be doing things to be pleasing men, man. Don't be trying to buy certain gifts, man, to not that be trying to buy Akim's guest man to be not to be to be pleased by men, man. That's off as hell, man. Should be being men pleased in the last day, man. That's off, man. To be treating everyone the same and the truth, not to be putting other brothers above, not to be putting other brothers below other. That slaps the word again. Not to be putting other brothers above other brothers in the truth, man. Treating everyone the same, man. Not to be putting certain brothers below other brothers, man. That's off as hell if you're doing that, man. You need to repent, man. Repent, man. I'm jumping to the fast. If you've got that wicked men pleaser spirit in you in the last day, to repent, man, and ask the Most High to purge out all that wickedness out of your system, man, because you shouldn't be moving in that wicked men pleaser spirit, man, in the last days, man, because I see it as well, man. It's off as hell, man, because I meant to be putting all that men pleaser spirit that you had in the world, man. Leave that behind, man, and jump onto the righteous spirit when you're in the truth, man. Not to be still having that worldly spirit that you had in the world, man. Not to be bring that same wicked spirit in the world into the truth, man. It's wicked, man. So let me get Proverbs 16 verse 5. Proverbs 16 verse 5. Everyone that is proud in heart is an abomination to the Lord. See that? Through though hand drawn in hand, he shall not be unpunished. So if you've got a wicked, demonic, prideful spirit in you, man, the Most High is going to destroy you, man. Because like Most High said in Proverbs 16 verse 5, man, it says, the proud is in heart is abomination to the Lord, man. Though hand drawn in hand, man, he shall not be unpunished. Or not to be unpunished if you still got that prideful, wicked spirit in you in the last day, man, especially against your own brother, man. The Most High is going to judge you for that, man. So recommend brothers that have prideful spirits in you, man, need to purge that all out your system, man. Because like not too long ago, we had the Day of Atonement, man. Meant to be putting all that wicked spirit that you had in the system, man. It's meant to be purging that out throughout your system, man, before the Day of Atonement kicked in, man, because the Day of Atonement wasn't too long ago, man. Even before the Day of Atonement kicked in, man, certain brothers should be fasting weekly anyway, man. Shouldn't just be fasting on the Day of Atonement, man. But the Day of Atonement is a very serious day to be fasting. The whole congregation, man, that keeps the Day of Atonement, man, they'll be in America, man, they'd be fasting as well, and brothers in the UK be fasting as well, man. So like brothers need to be keeping the commands and not to be having that envy or that wicked prideful spirit in them, man, because that prideful spirit in you, that's gonna get you licked down in the last days, man. So let me get three more precepts and close out, man. Proverbs 29 verse 23, a man's pride shall bring him low, and honor shall uphold the humble in spirit. See that? So a man, so I was saying before, man, a man's prideful spirit is going to bring him low, man. A man's prideful spirit can get him licked down on the last days, can get him killed, man. Because that low, that humble brother that in the truth might not know all them thoughts, breakdowns, all them dark sayings, how the other brother might know these dark sayings, but that same humble brother can get that brother that knows all them dark sayings, all them deep breakdowns or precepts, man, can get them saved in the last days, man. But as I'm saying, to let all that prideful spirit go from you, man, because certain brothers in the truth might not be able to read, man, because like certain brothers not learning difficulty, but obviously like might not be able to read like fluently like how other brothers read in them, man. That's what I'm saying, man. You can't be putting that brother down, man, because like, that same brother that can't bring it out or read fluently like how other brothers read, that brother can get saved in Jacob's trouble, that brother can get saved in the last days, man. So I'm saying to start looking at brothers at the same, man, not to be putting brothers down because you can't bring it out mattered in you, or can't bring out the precepts how you bring out the precepts, man. To be treating everyone the same in the truth, man, because that's what we lack on, like that's what Israel we lack on it's like, what's the word, that's what we what's the word again, that's what we slacking on, man. Basically, not showing brotherly love, man. Because that even this ain't a bright bread about brotherly love, but even in America, man, a lot of brothers in the truth, man, they like. Obviously, it's not all about unity camp, but certain brothers in the truth in America, man, they're. Can I say, man? They don't show brotherly love just on a Sabbath day when it's camp time, man. Cause I've seen a video man, I think it's Chief Ethan man said, what do you say again? I'm just gonna say it's a short thing what he said, man said. It doesn't have to be a feast day or doesn't have to be a feast day or a new moon, man, to be shown to be keeping the unity, man, with our brothers, man. Because that video, man, I think he was watching the boxing, man, after Shabbat, man. Or it wasn't after Shabbat, man, I think it was another day, man, I can't remember. But so it doesn't have to be a feast day, man, for brothers to be showing brotherly love, man. Because they was all in that one house, man. It was showing brotherly love, man, keeping the unity, man. It doesn't have to be a feast day for brothers to be showing unity, man, together, man. Because, yeah, man, so I'll say, man, so one thing we slack on, man, because America cat videos, man, see a lot of brothers be unity, it's a lot better, man. It's a lot, I'll say better, man, but it's, I say the unity is a lot more, yeah, I will say better, man. Unity is a lot more better in America because brothers ain't got no wicked spirits, and I'm not saying certain brothers in the UK got wicked spirits, but I'm saying the unity is a lot more better in America, man, because certain brothers in the UK, man, might have that prideful spirit in them, man, like they think, man, they're better than other brothers in certain camps, man. You need to let that all go, man, living in the last days, man. Can't you see what's happening in Russia, Ukraine, man, Israel and Gaza, man? You need to let that all go in the last days, man, because you got time to be playing about, man. All hell's gonna break loose soon, man, so brothers need to get in check, man, before all hell breaks loose, man. Got time to be playing about in the last days. Haven't got time to be having envy or prideful spirit on us in the last days, man. You need to let all that pridefulness go, man, because Not too long ago, we had Day of Atonement, man. We had Feast of Tabernacles, man. So, brothers, to take into account, man. So, then we get last two priests after the close out, man. Get Proverbs chapter 16, verse 18. Pride goeth before destruction. See that? And a haughty spirit before a fall. So, pride goeth before destruction, man. So, certain brothers that's got prideful spirit in them, man. Any brothers that's got or sisters got prideful spirit in them, to let that all go, man. All that doesn't get you let down or destroyed in the last days, man. To let all that prideful spirit go, man. Got time to be playing about, man. So, let me get one more priest after and close out, man. So, because don't matter how much stuff you know, man, don't matter how much deep breakdowns you know, or how many videos you do, man. Don't matter about that, man. All that matters is that you don't lose the faith in the last days. Don't denounce the Most High when all hell's breaking loose, when famine happens, man, when Jacob's troubles come to pass, man, when all these prophecies are getting fulfilled, man. Don't be denouncing the Most High in the last day, man. Just stay sturdy in the truth, man. Don't be coming out the truth, man. Stay sturdy, man. Don't be losing the faith, man. Just like how Obadiah from Yahushua messenger say, man, says, man, says, it's either two ways to so you say again, it's only two ways to die in the truth, man. In the truth or out of the truth, man. It's only two ways, man. So yeah, man, so let me get the last piece of today now, man, because yeah, man, can't be losing faith in the last days, man, because certain brothers can be in the truth for like 10 plus years, man, or 5 years, man, and certain brothers will be falling out of the truth, man, be going back to the gym, man, be going back in the world, man, enjoying yourself, man. Can't be enjoying yourself in the last days, man. Can't you see what's happening, man? Can't you see that prophecies are getting fulfilled, man? So let me get this last piece and close out now, man. So let me get Galatians chapter 6 verse 3. For if a man think, it's lucky, Galatians 6 verse 3. For if a man think himself to be something when he is nothing, he deceiveth himself. So if you think to yourself that if you're thinking to yourself that you know something, man, when he is nothing, man, he only deceived himself, man, because what are we in this earth, man? We're dust and ashes, man. I'm not talking about the other nations, I'm talking about the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, the 12 tribes of Israel, man. Our people, man. What God's chosen people, not no niggas on the earth, man. What God's chosen people, man. But same time, what dust and ashes, man. Need to be keeping, need to be treating each other the same, man. Can't be talking down to a brother just because that brother might not know deep breakdowns or dark sayings, just like how you know it, man. Cause everyone's given their own portion, man. One brother can might be able to bring up breakdowns. Another brother might be able to bring up able to teach people in highs and buyers, or teach people in general. And another brother, his talent might be able to hold posts or read, man, or be a cameraman, innit? Because everyone's got their own talents in the truth, man. No one's better than no other brother in the truth, man. Everyone's the same, man. Because that says, man, so a priest again, that trying to paraphrase him and that. So one, if you love your can't hate your brother that you've seen, innit? And can't, I said, get priests again, I'm just a prophet, I'm not gonna get on the prophet, so, saying, how can you love the most side how you haven't seen it? How can you, hate your brother that you have seen, innit? Just paraphrasing that priest, innit, man, because if he's showing everyone, not everyone, man, only the, the so-called blacks, the Spanish, the Americans, only the Israelites, man, the Hebrew Israelites, should be showing your people love, man, not these other nations, man, and should be hating other people, hating our own people as well, man, to be showing love and affection for our own people, man, not to be putting brothers down, man, to be uplifting brothers in truth, man. So with that, man, close up, man, give all praise to the Most High, how about Shem Yoshai, man. Hopefully to be edified when you watch this video, man. So let me see if I got anything off. I ain't got anything else. I'm gonna close out, man. One sec. Slack it. Yeah, I was gonna close up, but let me just read these last bits about pride, man. After I'm gonna close out after this, man. So might show it as well. Let me, that's it. So like you say, I'm trying to mess with my laptop, making my laptop slow, man. See that? So let me read this last bit about pride now. Basically pride focuses on others' failures, self-righteous, overly and fault finding. Looks at their life through a telescope, but others with a marrow scope. See that, man? Thing. Looks down on those who aren't. It's like he looks down on those who aren't. It's like, what's it say? Looks down on those who aren't as spiritual or committed as they are. Thinks they know who is truly proud and truly humble, thinks everyone is privileged to have them involved. See that? All that is pridefulness, man. Brothers and sisters, in the truth, to let all that prideful go on his last day, man. So that, man, to close out, give a praise to the Most High, Yahweh Bashim Nashai, man. Hope brothers and sisters can be edified when the video gets uploaded, man. So with that, man, to close out, man, give a praise to the Most High, Yahweh Bashim Nashai, man. Shalom, Kwame Shalom.